Guys, you can't imagine how many times I bought an item that was too expensive in retrospect or jumped the gun on a pricey gadget just before Black Friday. I mean, I'm no stranger to a bad deal, and that's why we're doing these videos, to point you to a smart investment and push you out of a bad one. Today, I'm gonna focus on all the ways Samsung Galaxy S21 FE is a good deal, even if it's a very late one. When Samsung used to launch them at the end of summer, these cut-down versions of a flagship pressed the right button. That is, folks in need of a good phone, but with barely any money left after vacation. Also, not too close to Black Friday to risk getting lost in the sea of awesome deals. But chip shortages and other issues delayed the production this year. S21 Fan Edition didn't show up at the end of August, and if you ask me, it won't come out this October 20. Yeah, I know, Samsung Unpacked will take place, but my guess is the company will go with software updates and not a brand new phone series. Actually, three other reliable leaksters agree. They bet S21 FE is gonna drop on January 11. Is Samsung planning to release it with the S22? Or is the flagship gonna come like a month later? They haven't said anything yet, but one thing's for sure. S22 will launch closely to the Fan Edition. So, you'll have to decide between the two. For many, that's gonna be a question of price. And for what I can tell, S21 FE should be less than $699, maybe even $650. It should be cheaper than the one before it. After all, Samsung cut the prices of this year's flagships. That's one of several things that you love about this phone, and what makes it a true fan edition. The other thing is the look. Okay, don't expect a huge shift from the vanilla model, but some slight changes that will tickle your fancy. Like more color. We're gonna be able to match our lifestyles with our phone's colors. Pale lavender and an earthy shade of green are gonna come out straight from the factory. Good to know if you like transparent covers or don't use any at all, you brave soul, you. Then, size. Samsung is taking out the extra, leaving us with a thinner phone while expanding the length and width. Side by side with a normal S21, you'll see the Fan Edition is wider and taller. But this won't affect the display whatsoever. You're still gonna play swap and tap on a 6.4-inch screen at a gaming-worthy refresh rate, 120Hz. Another thing I appreciate is Samsung dropping the metallic shade of the camera island. Why make the bump so obvious? I mean, its thickness is annoying enough. S21 FE will solve that issue and adopt the same color of the phone's back. By the way, the camera itself will probably be the most unexciting aspect of the phone. The Ultra Intelli will be back with a 12-megapixel main at least. I'm hoping Samsung gives us a 32 one though, especially if we won't have any new camera features. And that's just a warm-up. These four features are gonna be the ones that are really gonna make a difference in January, so keep your eyes wide open. I'm gonna get back to the processor and RAM, but as user experience goes, I think these two will matter more. I'm talking about the headphone jack and expandable storage. You'll have a slot for that micro SD card, and a way to avoid all the earbuds craziness. Ready for some more good news? What's a touchy subject for phone users? Battery. Let's be honest here, a one-day battery will disappoint even my dad, and he's not one to play games, shoot videos, or upgrade apps like all the rest of us. So, S21 FE will try its best with a 4,500 mAh cell. Yeah, that should extend your phone's life at least more than the S21 did. Plus, it's gonna charge way faster, cause guess what? It's gonna support 45W fast charging. Unlike the S21 Ultra, my friend, at $650, this phone is gonna be pretty badass. Sure, you won't get a Snapdragon 888 Plus, just the 888 or Exynos 2100. And yeah, Samsung won't upgrade it to 12GB of RAM, but honestly, we can do much with just 8, right? Really, this Fan Edition is gonna be something else. Better than the S21 and even S21 Ultra in some ways. Of course, it's gonna land in January, so I won't blame you if you go for a Pixel or wait for the S22. Oh, that's a hard one, gotta tell you. Hard to decide what's the better deal here. If you listen to your gut right now, right here, what phone would you go for? Let me know. Thanks for watching, and don't forget, subscribe and hit the bell button if you want to see more videos like this. It really means the world to us. See you guys!